Hi friends, welcome to our channel. In this session we will discuss SHA-512 algorithm. Here this SHA-512 is an authentication algorithm and it is an hash algorithm, and the name specifies SHA, means it is a secure hash algorithm. Secure hash algorithm. Generally we have different types of SHAs. That is SHA-0, SHA-1, SHA-2 and so on. In SHA-2, again we are divided into different types. In SHA-1, SHA-128, SHA-256, SHA-512, depending on output bits. For example, these algorithms are mainly dependent on output bits. If output is either 128 bit or 256 bit or 512 bits. If the output is either 128 bits output, 256 bits output or 512 bits output, depending on the outputs, this is called SHA-512. If it is a 512, this is called SHA-512. This is called SHA-256 and this one is called SHA-1. So depending on number of output bits, we are dividing the names. So we will discuss SHA-512, that is the number of output bits in this example is, that is in this algorithm is 512 bits. Okay. Now we will discuss what is the SHA algorithm and why, how to implement this algorithm. So before going the plain text, what is the size of plain text? The size of plain text is 1024 bits. Remember, here not the size of plain text. Here the size of plain text block. The size of plain text block. That is, the entire plain text is divided into different number of blocks. Each block size is 1024 bits. Each block size is 1024 bits. And number of rounds in this SHA-512 algorithm is 80. So first one is the plain text block size, and the number of rounds we are performing is 80, and each round we are performing different set of functions. That is, on each round we are performing different operations. So to perform different operations, each round will produce a what? Suppose each round it produces, here it means the plain text produces a Q word called W of size 64 bits. In each round it produces a Q word of size 64 bits. So how we are generating this W is generated from the plain text. We will show the diagram. Next we will discuss the diagram. That's in the diagram it is very clear. So we are generating that one. Now next one is, in this algorithm, that is on each round we are using a constant K. On each round we are using some constants K. This K, it is a constant, generally it is in hexadecimal format. These constants are generally in hexadecimal format. Similarly, and we are using buffers also. We are using buffers. What is the purpose of buffer? The main purpose is to store the intermediate results and finally to store the outputs, to store results. Either intermediate results or final results. Here, output of one block in this, output of one block is input to next block in the SHA algorithm. So here clearly observe, our plain text is divided into different number of blocks. On each block we are performing 80 rounds. On each block we are performing 80 rounds. So on completion of 80 rounds for block 1, that is transferred to the input for the next block. That is transferred to the input for the next block. On the next blocks also we are performing total 80 rounds. and this is completed until the blade test complete, and final block produces the hash code. Whatever the final block produces, that is the hash code, that is output of our algorithm. So on each block, along with the plain test, we are applying these buffers also. Plain test, we are applying these buffers also. So how many number of buffers we require? What is the size of output? Size of output is 512 bits. Each buffer size is 64 bits. So total 512 and buffer size is 64. So 64 into 8. So we need 8 buffers. Okay. And the names of buffers are A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. These are the 8 buffers used in our program. 8 buffers used in our program. So this is clear. This is clear. Now we will move to the algorithm. So after identify all this, so I erase this one. What is the step procedure? Procedure is padding. Almost all algorithm, the first step is padding. Here what is padding? Means we are taking the input. Here size of each block is 1024 bits. For example, if my plain text size is some 1025. If my plain text size is 1025, what we will do? I am dividing the plain text of one block of size 1024 and another block of size only 1 bit. But it is invalid in this algorithm. Each block necessarily definitely contains 1024 bits. So I am padding these 1023 bits. So what is our first step? Our step is padding of the plain text. So padding the bits. Pad the bits. So what is the condition? Pad the bits with, remember, 100 and so on, starting with 1 and 0. Suppose this is our bit, 10000 and so on. Padding the bits such that it is multiple of 1024. Multiple of 1024. That means if our number is, suppose our test size is 1025 bits, I am pad the bits such that it is multiple of 1024, means 1024 into 2, suppose 2048. This 1025 bits is converted into 2048 bits. And at the time of padding, remember, at the time of padding, leave last 128 bits. Leave last 128 bits. That means, suppose this is our number, 1024 is added. 1024 is added. Next, how many numbers? 1024. In this 1024 number, forget 128 bits. This 128 bits is plain text. I am padding only these bits. For example, this is the remaining bit at this position 1. I am padding only this one. That means, how we pad the bits? We padding the bit such that it is less than 128. It is less than 128 multiples of 1024. In second step, add 128 plain text at the end. 128 bit plain text at the end. That means by combining step 1 and step 2, we are getting a plain text which is multiple of 1024. We are getting a plain text which is a multiple of 1024. And remaining algorithm is very simple. Remaining one is use buffers and perform the operation on each block and each round. After completion of one round, that result is transferred to next round. So total complete all the 80 rounds. After completion of 80 rounds, result is transferred to the next block. So we will discuss the diagram. By understanding the diagram, it is very clear. The SHA algorithm is very simple. What is the diagram? First, I am getting a plain text. For example, if my message is M. So this is the message. In this message, I am padding some bits. Suppose if it is a not multiple of 1024 bits. If it is not multiple of, for example, number of bits are some LBs. If our message is LBs, if it is not multiple, what we will do? I am doing padding. After padding, I will add 128 bits. After padding, I am adding 128 bits at L. So in this L bits, I am adding 128 bits. So here I am applying, in this position I am applying padding. Now you got it. Now total this is our original message. Now actually this is the message. After performing step 1, step 2, step 3, this is the original message. How many number of blocks? Suppose we don't know number of blocks. N into 1024 bits. The size of entire message, the size of entire message is multiple of 1024 bits. Now what we will do? This entire message is divided into different number of blocks. This message is divided into different number of blocks and so on. And so on. For example, blocks M1, M2, M3, and so on, MM. Size of each block is? What is the size of each block? Size of each block is 1024 bits. We have n number of blocks. So each block 1024, 1024, and so on, 1024. Now what we will do on each block, that is the number of bits are 1024. On each block, we are applying a function f. We are applying a function f. What are the inputs? Next, we will discuss what we will do in that function. This is the overall diagram. What is the input for this function? Input for the function is our block, that is our plain text, and initial vector. Randomly, we are choosing some initial vector, and the size of initial vector is 512 bits. The size of initial vector is 512 bits. This is input. This is input. After completion of this one, after completion of this one, what we will do? Perform. This is not XOR operation. This is addition modulo 64. Addition modulo 2 power 64. But to perform operation, minimum two operands required. One is output of F. Second one is this one. Suppose initially this is called some H0. That is hash 0 output. Hashing is H0. So after applying function F, we are getting some output. This output and the previous H0, we are performing module addition. Now it produces, suppose it produces H1. So the same logic. Now the function F and this H1. Now the function F and this H1, it produces some output. This one and this one. So the same procedure is repeated. For example, F. We are getting, suppose this is HN minus 1. We are getting some HN. After performing all the operations, we are getting some HN. This is the hash code. This is our required hash code. Observe, the plain text is divided into blocks. On each block, I am performing a function F. On each block, I am performing a function F. It generates some output. And this output, addition modulo 2 power 64 with the initial H0 value. Initial H0 value. Here IV. IV is the initial vector. IV is the initial vector. This is the diagram. So observe, we are getting hash code. Now we will move to what we will do on each round. What is our task on each round? That is on function F, what we will do. Now we will move the round function. Okay, it is clear. What is the round function? Round function is, in the round function, that is in the F, what we will use? I am using the buffers A, B, C, D, F. GH. Suppose I am using the buffers A2H. So to provide input. Next, remember the point. Remember in the function F, I am providing one arrow, that is M. One input is from M, another one is from initial vector. So I am getting message. This is the message. From the message, in the algorithm we will discuss, in each round we are generating a word. In each round we are generating a word. Suppose the word name is Q word. First round W0. What is the input? Here A, B, C, D, F, G, H, all are called buffers. A to Z are called buffers. Suppose all these buffers are applied for round 0. The buffers are applied for round 0. And after completion of round 0, it produces some output. For round 0, this is input. After completion of round 0, it produces some output. This is input to the this output. This output is input to the round one, and so on. And the last one is, we are starting from round 0. That's why, and the last one is round 79. Here the diagram is not completed clearly. W79. So observe, in each round I am using buffers to store the temporary data, to store the intermediate results. After completion of one round, we are moving to next round. And what is the input to the buffer? In the previous diagram, we are using H0. The input for round 1 is H0. So I am providing, suppose HI minus 1. If you are using the first block H1 minus 1 H1 for the next round, so I am using HI minus 1. After completion of all rounds, what it gets? It gets HI. So suppose this one. What we will do? After this entire thing is F. Remember, this entire thing is F. After completion of round 17, we are applying this operation. I think you got 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So I think you got it. All these round 0 to round 9 are F. After completion of F, we have two inputs. What are the two inputs? One is output of F. Second one is H0. So this is H0. So for F, input is, output of F is this one, and This is H0. I think you got the point. You got it. After completion of all this, what we will get? After completion, we will get H1. That is HI minus 1, HI. So, in the previous one, what we will do? M, for this M, I am getting the function F. Function F, I am providing H0 as the input. It provides some output. This is we are doing. It will produce some H1. After applying, it produces H1. So here this is our case. Here this is the case. On each F we are performing 80 rounds. For example, we have 4 blocks in our algorithm. We have 4 into 80, 320 rounds are performed. So F, this round 2, round 79 F, H0 is the initial hash code and XR operations, the input is output of F plus H0, it produces HI. This HI is moved to second block, that is moved to next block until completion of all the messages. Okay, this is the secure hash algorithm block diagram and then each round operation. Next we will move to, in each stage we are developing words. How we are generating the words? Words are generated from plain text. Now we will move how words are generated. This is the way to generate the words. This is the formula. For example, suppose you consider block M1. Number of bits is 1024 bits. From 1024 bits, size of each word is 64. So we are generating 16 words. Word 0, word 1 and so on, word 16. So 16 into 64, 1024 bits. So first 16 there is no problem. To generate the next 16, the formula is, consider these words from the first 16, W0, W1, W9, W14. Apply sigma naught, sigma 1 on W1, W14. Perform XR operations, we are getting W16. In a similar fashion, we are taking next 2 pairs. A similar next 2 pairs to get W17 until our required number of words is reached. This is the formula. Suppose how to get WT? Suppose to get W16, what is the formula? Sigma 1 512 of WT minus 2. For example, to get 16, to get W16, we are using W14. So observe, we are using W14 on sigma 1 function. And WT minus 15, that is 16 minus 1, W1 on sigma 0 function. Along with I am using W0 and W14, that is WT minus 7, WT minus 16. That is based on these 15 words, we are generating new words. So here what is sigma 1252, sigma 0252? This is the formula. Rotation, ROTR means shift right or shift rotate. ROTR, for example, ROTR n comma x. Rotate x by n number of bits. Rotate x by n number of bits. So after performing all these operations, we are generating total 80 watts on each round. We are generating a total of 80 watts on each round. After completion of this one, how the buffers are changed? How the buffers are changed? We will discuss how buffer changed in this one. On this algorithm, finally, what happens on each round? Each round we are generating 80 watts. At the same time, each round we are generating 80 constants. Here K means a constant, KT means constants. This is the procedure, that is between these buffers, one buffer to another buffer, we are providing input to the first buffer. From first buffer, output is moved to second and second to third. What happens in between those? For these 79, 0 to 79, that is 80 rounds. So A to H, these are the 512 bits. These are the 512 bits. On these 512 bits, we are generating finally 512 bits. In between these two, this is happens. So first buffer A, whatever the value present in buffer A, that is directly transferred to buffer B. The buffer A value is transferred to buffer B. So this one. And buffer B value is transferred to buffer C. So B value is transferred to buffer C. And buffer C value is transferred to buffer D. So each step, A value is transferred to B, B value is transferred to C, C value is transferred to D. So shift bits. And at the same time, E value is transferred to directly, not F. E value, suppose see this one, E value is directly transferred to F. F value is transferred to G. G value is transferred to H. All these are okay. What is this one? Here what happens to E value and what happens to A value? Observe, A value is copied to B, B is copied to C, C is copied into D, C is copied into D. So for that E, E is copied into F, F is copied into G, G is copied into H. But what about this A value, this E value? First we are performing this operation. We are following the same sequence. Remember, we are follow the same sequence. E is equal to D plus T1. So this is the plus operation, D plus T1. So these are the words. Suppose we are using kth round, TK, fifth round, T5. So what is the formula for T1 and T2? This is the formula H plus, this is a conditional function of buffers EFG. H plus EFG for end sigma for the buffer E, WT plus KT. Similarly, here we are using some majority function. So these are the formulas. Majority function. Here the majority function is applicable for buffer ABC. So A and B, B and C, C and J, C and A. Between AB, perform, this is the logical end operation. AB, BC, CA. This is the majority function. Similarly, conditional function. EFG, E and F, not E and G. This is the conditional function. That is, if E is true, not E means false, false and true. And what are the sigma functions? Simply, these sigma functions are rotate functions. For example, sigma 0 to 512 of A means rotate of A. Rotate of A means rotate 28 of A. That is, an 8 is rotated by 28 bits. With 34, with 29. This is an A. Suppose it is a rotation on A. This is the final secure hash algorithm. If you remember the block diagram, from this block diagram, we are getting each and every round separately. This is secure hash algorithm, SHA-512. In the next session, we will discuss HMAC algorithm. Thank you.